classically speaking, assist has got a smooth, a very smooth surface. We call this assist. When the assist not have a smooth surface, when will assist not have a smooth surface?
Rupture. If it's malignant or has papillae.
Infected. Fibrosis. If it's a multilocular cyst, it may well not be a small surface. It's a tiny consistency. A. Soft your heart. The consistency at times, it's not very easy in the breast to elicit fluctuation. It's not very easy in the breast to elicit fluctuation because the classically speaking, a cyst is tracheal. But it's not very easy to elicit that in the breast. But it's soft if it's lax and it's hard if it's dense. You all know how a cyst simulates malignancy. A cyst is a very good lesion usually, but it simulates malignancy if it's hard, because it's tense. It feels hard if it's tense. A tense cyst anywhere in the body feels hard. A tense cyst anywhere in the body feels hard, and then it can mimic a malignant lesion. A cyst may be mobile. A cyst may have the same feature as a fibroadenoma. It may very well be mobile. There should be no lymph nodes. A cyst develops perimucosal and it's got a smooth surface, maybe a smooth pain. It's soft to firm, as soft to hard. It's really mobile and there shouldn't be lymph nodes. If there are lymph nodes, maybe reactive. Carpenter fiber adenosis, a reactive lymphadenopathy. Benign, ugly, small, seed, mobile, exhibit, it is possible. It's unlikely, but it's possible. But it's cyst. Also, it's painless and the surface?
Irregular.
The surface is irregular and the consistency?
Hard.
Hard. When you're describing something in a comparison table, you mention the classic thing. There are variants, but you mention the classic things. Otherwise, it's very messy. And the classic things are about to be met with. Well, I mention classic things that have the common things. Immobility?
Immobile.
Common. A breast carcinoma is immobile. Immobile, meaning that it is fixed within the breast tissue. In the fibroadenoma, the cyst may be mobile within the breast. The people when you assess the mobility of a lump, you assess the relation to the skin, to the breast, to the pectoralis, to the chest wall. And to have this is even critical. Assess it to the skin, to the breast tissue, to the pectoralis, and the latest possibly. Try the chest wall and head chest wall, meaning the rings. Would you like to tell me something about fibroadenoma? Okay, go on.
It's young age.
Young age, the fibroadenoma is develops in young females. Are you
Pain, painless.
It is painless, the fibroadenoma should not be painful. Yes?
Smooth or elevated surface.
It may be a smooth or elevated surface, yes. And the consistency?
Soft
or firm, usually it's firm. Soft or firm, usually it's firm, yes. How about the mobility?
Highly mobile.
Highly mobile, exactly. Fibroadenoma is a highly mobile lesion. In fact, it is the only solid lesion as of the rest, it does not become attached to it. Bear in mind the halo that you see on the mammogram. The nucleation. At times there are suction devices, by the way, there are methods to excise lesions in the breast using suction devices, because they are highly mobile, not attached, you can actually treat them by suction. And the lymph nodes should obviously be negative. There should be no nodes. There shouldn't be any nodes whatsoever. يلا رضوان لنا الاندي شكلها عامل ازاي الاندي it's usually painful, as is usually a painful condition. They have a terminal nostalgia at the surface. What you could feel nodularity, painful nodularity, and the aortic correlate and the painful nodularity. A painful nodularity and possibly a lymphadenopathy that is wide and small and distinct and so on. The consistency is firm. It's an undefined lesion that is firm and is not attached and may not be fed by the lab. It's not mobile. A few differential diagnoses concerning breast cancer.
Lymphadenopathy مع ال fibrocystic disease.
بتبقى لأنه in the sense there is a bit of infiltration, cellular infiltration. At one stage they used to call it. Now this is not a term that we use commonly nowadays. You used to call it chronic interstitial mastitis. There's a bit of cellular infiltration, so for the nodes react. But they shouldn't be anything significant. So we all know that you can assess the nodes even sonographically or mammographically, and you can more or less reliably reach or conclude that they're not neoplastic. You can assess the nodes. Obviously, it's not very accurate as a biopsy, but you can. If you assess the axilla clinically, this is very inaccurate. It's very inaccurate. You may think there are no nodes, it turns out to be there are nodes. You may think the nodes are negative, it turns out to be positive. You may think they're positive, it turns out to be negative. And I'm talking about extreme forms. Like an ultrasonography can be more accurate. And mammography, it can detect, tell you something about the architecture of the node. Node, if you remember histology, there's the cortex and the medulla, of the sinuses and so on. في follicles, lymph follicles within the node, وفي capsule وفي hilum وقصة ظريفة كده. This was the importance of histology, لأنه the ultrasonographer has to make sure that the architecture is normal. So, and so does the pathologist. It was very important to know that. يعني there may be reactive with the node. Anyway, عشان نظيف التريبي كلمة treatment هذا كان رجع على حسب كلمة pathologist. طبعاً زي ما انتم شايفين ايه لازم الحاجة برضه تبقى لما تبقى الحاجة very well very spread كده بتبتدي شكلها يبقى متلخبط يعني فلازم تبقى شوية كومباكت فعاوزين نتكلم على special features of breast carcinoma. The breast carcinoma cells have got the ability to produce certain products, they've got certain receptors in the wall. انتوا عارفين الكلام ده طبعاً مش كده ولا ايه؟ فبيطلعوا ساعات يبقوا بيطلعوا ايسترن ريسبتورز بيطلعوا بيبقوا ايسترن ريسبتورز الورقه دي في الورقه الاولانيه خالص بتاعت البريست كانسر اللي فيها الفي دي ان يو والدكتور بتاعت امبارح دي باثولوجي اوف بريست كانسر. واحنا خرجنا للجدول ده ليه؟ خرجنا للجدول ده كنا بنتكلم على اكزيمال فاليو انفرانتيك كارسينوما فيرسس الابسس. If you remember talking about cancer with special features, cancer with inflammatory manifestations, cancer with nipple affection, cancer with a lipomatous component. I can remember the special features were the presence of an estrogen receptor in the wall of the cell, which means that this tumor is usually responsive to hormonal therapy. يعني انتوا عارفين لما الواحد يشيل breast lump it turns out to be carcinoma. The pathologist tells you I can assess the estrogen receptor status. And if the ER status is positive, then usually these individuals, not necessarily, but usually respond to hormonal therapy. Talking about one well known method of treating breast cancer is hormonal therapy. حاجة ما تخفاش على حد، طرق علاج البريست كانسر، معروفة ايه طرق علاج البريست كانسر؟ ايه وايه وايه وايه؟ يعني حاجة لأن احنا بنتكلم عن تريتمنت دلوقتي كمان شوية، أول حاجة نقولها وات ار ذا أوبشنز؟ أند ذيس ار ذا أوبشنز. سيرجيكال تريتمنت، راديو ثيرابي، هرمونال ثيرابي، كيمو ثيرابي. طب الهرمونال ثيرابي از ليس has got less complications than chemo. If you want to choose something, you prefer to give hormonal, except that you want something that is effective. One of the predictors is the presence of an ER. Okay? The estrogen receptor. الحاجة التانية مش بس الريسبتور ريسبتور ساعات يبقى كمان في بروجسترون ريسبتور ممكن كمان يبقى في بي جي ار ممكن يبقى في بروجسترون ريسبتور طبعا if someone has got an ER positive status you can then give them an anti-estrogen the well-known anti-estrogen as you all know
تاموكسيفن
حاجة معروفة لكل البني آدمين طبعا تاموكسيفن is the well-known standard anti-estrogen لكن طبعا on the other hand in the past before tamoxifen appeared we used to remove the ovaries نشيل الأوفريز ونعم بقى في لابروسكوي نشيل الأوفريز لابروسكوبيك because these are local ovaries that we remove وكنا we used to go too far and if we remove the ovaries and take recurve we used to remove the adrenals and at times we went too far and we removed the pituitary وكنا نقول كده لكن طبعا الكلام دلوقتي بقى كله medical counterparts بقينا نعمله medical ندي تاموكسيفن او ندي حاجة ضد الادرينال كده عارف ان الدواء اللي ضد الادرينال اسمه ايه؟ في دواء كده ضد الادرينال اسمه امينو جلوتي
ايوه
امينو جلوتامايت هنتكلم عليها كمان دقيقتين كده اوكي في اي ار وبي ار دول هو ريسبتورز لكن في حاجه كمان انا سمعتها اليرت طبعا مش كده؟ اللي هي هيومن ابيدرمال بلوك فاكتور ريسبتور يعني a few cancer cells belonging to breast cancer have got a receptor in the wall, a transmembrane receptor that responds to a variety of epidermal growth factors. بيقول عليها HER2 receptor, بيسموها HER2. HER2 اللي هي human epidermal growth factor receptor. بيسموها HER2. The human epidermal growth factor receptor. This is the receptor. It responds if this is the receptor that is present in the cell membrane and it's a transmembrane. Yani the receptor extends from the inside to the outside. And HER2. Something that that is important in the clinic and in the treatment. If he antibody that they've developed against the HER2. With the concept of the receptor. So this is the concept of what we call. This is not hormonal, this is not chemo, this is not surgery, this is not radio, this is biological therapy. You already have biological therapy. It's a more biological therapy. You already have biological therapy. We need to address as a fact that if it does not respond to chemotherapy, and it's HER2, it is the role of a receptor to deal with it. But the growth factor receptor in the wall, we will have HER2. It's about HER2. We have a problem. We have a problem. But we will have HER2. It's about HER2. We will have HER2. And you can obviously assess whether the tumor is HER2 positive or negative. We will have the DCIS and the expression of HER2 after for an odd reason. But if it's HER2 positive, what can you move? Bendine receptor. The receptor is a monoclonal antibody that is developed against the HER2. It blocks the HER2 so that the epidermal growth factor does not stimulate the growth of breast carcinoma. We know that HER2 positive breast cancer is of worse prognosis. And if you allow a receptor status for teratogen negative, it's a triple negative breast cancer.
Triple negative.
عشان على طول triple assessment, triple assessment في what we call triple negative breast cancer. Triple negative breast cancer اللي هو negative ER, negative PGR, negative HER2. وتشكل اسامي شكرا بيبقى في expression of cytokeratins بيبقى في on the other hand انا مش عارف بس ادخل في كلام نظري كتير لان احنا طبيعي احنا مايند بالايه في الاول وفي الاخر مايند بالبراكتس مش مايند a bit of knowledge طبعا بس مايند في الاخر بالبراكتس فمش عاوزين نقعد ندخل لكن the tumors that do not express the three receptors express cytokeratins ايا كان ده معناه مش مهم لكن triple negative breast cancer is a worse prognosis triple negative لا it's worth even knowing this term زي ما كنا بنعدي كنا assessment triple assessment تكتبين triple negative breast cancer اللي هو ولا ER positive ولا EGR positive, voila, HER2 positive. HER2 and HER2 that, HER, 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 his, her, HER, he stands for human epidermal growth factor receptor. Human epidermal growth factor receptor. We mentioned epidermal growth factors casually when we're talking about the thyroid, because epidermal growth factors can cause the growth of a lot of structures inside the body. If this receptor is positive, you can use the technique that we call biological therapy. You can move her, you are a lead receptor, an antibody, monoclonal antibody against that. If you come in the muscular endothelial growth factors, yeah, times, يعني هو التيومر ده بيج وان ازاي بيج وان الطريق the stimulation of the cellular growth and also the stimulation of the angiogenesis in general بيبقى في ساعات vascular endothelial growth factor growth factors causing more angiogenesis وفي الاخر كمان في ال A ال P53 بتاع في ال P53 كنا بندور عليه قبل كده ايه؟
انتي كارسنجيك
To talk about that, I'm going to tell you about oncogenes, oncogenes that are responsible for oncogenesis. Well, there are two types. They are the tumor suppressor genes and the tumor activating genes. Oncogenes, genes that stimulate the growth of tumors. That's oncogenes. A tumor suppressor gene. A tumor suppressor gene. A normal cell will suppress the tumors, but if it becomes mutant or it becomes suppressed, if you suppress the tumor suppressor, the tumor can develop. Okay, and on the other hand, there are the proto-oncogenes. The proto-oncogenes, the genes that are responsible for the development of tumors. But if the proto-oncogene is activated, if Adam and Adam will be yellow, or if a mutant towards the development of a tumor, you will be yellow. Now, the P53 is the most famous, and it's been nicknamed the guardian of the human genome. But a mutant, the presence of a mutant P53 indicates that this tumor is worse for those who are in P53. They assess the amount of cellular proliferation, and they assess the amount of DNA within the cells. اللي بيقول عليها تكنيك بيسموه flow cytometry. حاجة مهمة لأنها بتتكتب everywhere ففي تكنيك بيسموه flow cytometry. You like flow cytometry. It assesses the amount of DNA within the cells and it assesses the amount of the cells within the S phase fraction. The S phase fraction بتاعت cell cycle. The S phase اللي هي الإيه؟ It's synthetic. اللي هي بتسنتسايز فيها DNA. S phase fraction. P is our resting phase, or P G phase, like a little bit of S phase. And S phase, yani P technique. I'm sure a few of you, whether you think you like it now or you don't, I'm sure first, as I'm sure a few of you will become clinical pathologists, lab doctors, حاجة ظريفة قوي, and دول اللي بيعملوا research. مش شرط تكونوا عارفين ومش شرط تكونوا حافظينها دلوقتي لكن you never know what things are kept for you يعني these people, these lab doctors perform at times the test that we call flow cytometry. Flow cytometry. ايه الفلو cytometry ده تكنيكي احنا مالناش دعوه طبعا بالتكنيك لكن الفلو cytometry what is the value of this test? It assesses the amount of DNA within the cells and it also assesses what we call the S phase fraction. The S phase fraction, the S phase fraction of the cells. The smaller the cell, as in the smaller the tumor, كل ما tumor was higher, كل ما يبقى growth down أكثر ولا أقل. When the tumor is small, Your octum. Okay. A small tumor proliferates much more than a big tumor. When the tumor attains a big size, most of the cells become resting. And khalas, there is no stimulus for it to grow. But the smaller the tumor, the more active the cells. The bigger the tumor, the less active the cells. And that concept is that the chemotherapy is small. The chemotherapy is effective, كل ما tumor is proliferating. If it's resting, chemotherapy will be less effective. فتلاقوا الواحد بيأسس the S phase fraction. The S phase fraction is bigger the smaller the tumor. The S اللي هي the synthetic phase of the cell cycle. انتوا عارفين في cell cycle وفي ال S phase fraction بتاعتها. كمية ال DNA اللي موجودة زي ما انتوا عارفين normally في كام كروموزوم؟ كام؟ كام؟ 46 كام بير؟ 23 يعني مش كده يعني 22 pair of sex chromosomes حاجة معروفة للكل المالتيبلز بيسموها بلويدي المالتيبلز بتاعتي بيسموها بلويدي مالتيبلز of 23 و 46 are called ايوبلويدي ايو انت عارفين ايو
نورمال
لو هي not multiples هيقول عليها ايوبلويدي فمش هتنفع بيسموها ايوبلويدي ايه يعني لما الواحد يحط ايه قبل حاجه يعني نيجاتيف وايو مش هتنفع ايو مش هتنفع فاني بوينت يقول لها اني بوينت النمبر اوف كروموزومز انسايد ذا سيلز از 23 بيرز 22 اند ا بير اوف اكس اند واي ولا اكس اكس اللي هم ذا جندر كروموزومز زي ما انتوا كلكم عارفين المالتيبلز اوف ذس از كول بلويدي وايو بلويدي ذير بلويدي ploidy ploidy يعني multiples of the 23 multiples of the 23 دي لسه ودي normal ايو ploidy ايو تعرفين ايو thyroid ومش عارف ايه ايو يعني good يعني peaceful يعني whatever it is لكن الواحد عاوز يقول the number of the chromosomes are not multiple are not the multiple of 23 هيقول ايه ايو ploidy مش هتنفع فيقول عليها aneuploidy حط الان بس عشان تبقى between the two vowels the term aneuploidy means that the number of the chromosomes is not a multiple of the normal يقول عليها aneuploidy فدي كلها حاجات بتبقى detected مش بس هذا هنا in so many other tumors البريست كانسر سيلز كل ما يبقى فيها حاجات كده كل ما يبقى فيها مايكوزس اكتر كل ما البروجنوز بتاعها هيبقى اوحش.
طب what does the S phase fraction indicate?
The S phase fraction indicates that the tumor is proliferating. The cells are proliferating. And to, if you want to grade breast cancer, you want to assess how much glands are there, how much pleomorphism is there, and how much mitotic figures are there according maybe to the amount of the DNA. But we assess the amount of DNA and how much cells are in the synthetic phase. It's about flow cytometry. It's about flow cytometry. Okay? هنتكلم بقى دلوقتي على حاجة أسهل أوي اللي هي إيه؟ اللي هي the treatment of breast cancer. ففي في ورقتين كده عايزين نوزعهم. يلا نوزع دي فاضي. فكرني اسمك. أنا زعلت كويس جدا. أنا بنسأل أشياء جدا بس مضطر أتعامل معاك. أنا آسف يا سعيد أني أتعامل معاك طبعا. حد يجي ورايا ومين هيجي ورايا. أوكي. أنت سارة؟
البسكر
ان شاء الله. البريست كانسر لو انتوا حاطين Because there are so many options. If your options keep your eye on leg, A, B, A.
بس قبل كلمة السيرجي محمود ايه كومبوننتس بتاعت البريست كانسر؟
In components is breast cancer, but what can component breast cancer as a disease? As a disease. If you can component, you can make a lot of money. في local, في regional, في systemic. زي ما كنا قلنا a few days ago. The components of breast cancer are actually three. A local component, a regional component, and a systemic, also a systemic component. And it's well known that breast cancer is usually systemic from the start. And the concept of treating breast cancer, the concept of managing breast cancer is that we have to know that breast cancer is a systemic disease. Certain cancers are not systemic. P-cancers are not known to be systemic from the start, but so we know that breast cancer is a lot of times systemic from the beginning. We have to classify the forms of treatment into local forms and systemic forms. In local forms, عندنا أربع طرق عندنا أربع طرق للعلاج وعندنا كم جزء في المرض عندنا local والريجنال and systemic. والسيستميك بيبقى مايكرو سيستميك وبيبقى ماكرو سيستميك. مايكرو when it's not there you cannot detect it, but you know it's highly possible that it's there. اللي هو اللي بيبريدكت كده هو the status of the lymph nodes. If the lymph nodes is positive, this simple fact predicts that there is systemic disease. Okay, وزي ما بتقولوا اللوكال that goes منه the lump itself, لكن the rest of the breast, because the tumor may very well be multicentric. Okay, but multicentric. If the tumor is multicentric, then if you remove the lump alone, then you haven't done a lot. You've removed the lump, but there are other centers harboring the tumor, other tumors. But عشان ما تسنتسيتي ولا لو مش هنوش كله يبقى يريمو ده لام وده سيفتي مارجن and then it to recur and then to minimize instances of recurrence. What do you do as an alternative to removing the whole breast?
Chemo.
Chemo. Chemo kills the systemic. Chemo and hormonal are systemic forms.
Radio.
You did not grasp the concept. I find it usually difficult and then I convey this concept. Surgery and radiotherapy are local forms. Surgery and radiotherapy are local forms of treatment. But some of them should have said, oh, you if you remove the breast cancer, you're avoiding the metastasis. But the surgery and radiotherapy are local forms. Chemo and hormonotherapy are systemic forms. But as a part of the systemic management, they also manage the breast, part of the breast on the body. Okay, like in defect, whenever you choose the treatment of breast cancer, you have to include within your treatment something for the local, something for the regional, something for the systemic. If you've given something for each component, then you have successfully treated this individual. If you haven't, then you're missing upon a component. Okay, you have to all together. Because the breast, there is a lump in the multicentricity. You either remove the breast. If you don't remove it, you irradiate the rest of the breast. Why do you irradiate the rest of the breast?
To minimize surgery.
عشان المulticentricity. عشان the instances of recurrence are shifting multicentricity. And if you cannot give radiotherapy, then you cannot perform wide open excision. To that extent, if this lady is contraindicated, you cannot give radiotherapy in this situation, then you cannot perform a wide open excision, you have to perform a mastectomy. If I'm pregnant, for example, مش ممكن أعملها wide open excision. مش هتنفع تاخد radiotherapy. يبقى الوايد اوبن اكسجن فيها ممنوع. لأن مش هينفع تاخد radiotherapy. شرط إن احنا نعمل wide open excision ندي radiotherapy. ليه؟ لهذا السبب. زي ما بيقولوا أو زي ما مكتوب مش عارف مكتوب هنا ولا لأ اللي هو السيرجي والريديوثيرابي ار لوكال فورمز والكيمو والهرمونال ار سيستميك فورمز. ايه الايم اوف ذا تريتمنت؟ ايه الايم احنا بنعالج الناس دول ليه؟ على حسب بالظبط على حسب ايه قول يا احمد ايه عاوز تعمل ايه الهدف بتاعك؟
If it's curable and then I cure the disease.
بالظبط،
إذا
كان الإيم إز ذا كيور، واللي هو نو لوكال نو سيستميك ديزيز ويبقى كده بنحسن بنزود نظريه السرفايفل بتاعه او بيبقى اتس نورمال انكيوربل فبنعمل لهم ايه بنعمل بنيشن هم دول اهداف يا اما التايم تشيف دول اور تايم يو جاست تشيف اور ايم از جاست بنيشن طيب هنبتدي نتكلم بعد ال بعد ال هنبتدي نتكلم على السيرفيكال فيتو بتاعت البريست كانسر احنا عددنا الاوبشنز بعد كده نبتدي نتكلم على كيدنج اوف ايتش بعد كده لما تخلص الديتيلز بتاعت الاربعه دول هنبتدي نتكلم على the stages, the individual stages, what do you do for each of the stages? هو ده اللي احنا عايزينه في الاخر، مش عايزين التفاصيل دي. لكن يبقى أول حاجة عايزين نعمل على كل واحدة الفورمز زي ما قلنا الايم والانديكيشنز والفورمز والكومبليكيشنز والحاجات الجديدة. فالواحد لما بيعمل جراحة للبريست كانسر ممكن يعمل ايه؟ أو زي ما هو مكتوب. ممكن يعمل ايه لعلاج البريست كانسر جراحيا؟ يبقى عندنا حاجتين البراكتس دي عامله حاجتين يا اما بنكونزرف البريست يا اما نعمل مستكتومي زي ما كنا بنقول if you're going to treat breast cancer you got one of two choices am I going to remove the breast or am I going to conserve فبيبقى الكونزرف تريتمنت يا اما بنعمل كوادرنتكتومي يا اما واجوكال اكسيجن ويسموها ساعات كوات وطات كوات اللي هو quadrantectomy, axillary evacuation, and radiotherapy. لأن احنا قلنا إذا كنا نعمل breast conservation, there is a must. Radiotherapy becomes mandatory. You have to irradiate. What do you irradiate after removing the lump alone?
The whole breast.
The rest of the breast. You irradiate the rest. You don't. It's not irradiation of the axilla. You irradiate the rest of the breast because you're worried. If you perform a mastectomy, خلاص, you remove the breast. فما فيش بقى multi centricity, بس if you remove only the lump, then you're worried about other centers that cause a higher incidence of recurrence than if you perform a mastectomy. But how do you avoid this problem? You irradiate the breast as a rule, to the extent that if you cannot give a radiotherapy for any reason, then you will not be able to perform a total excision. عندنا quadrantectomy, اللي هي quadrantectomy, axillary evacuation, and RT stands for radiotherapy. And then TART, tumorectomy, axillary evacuation, radiotherapy. And then wide open excision. A centimeter around the lesion. You remove a centimeter around the lesion. A ton less, Kevin. And then like on the other hand, we've got forms of mastectomy. And then forms of mastectomy. Number eight. الستاندرد مستكتب هي الموديفايد راديكال الام ار ام اللي كنا بنقولها الموديفايد راديكال مستكتب which remove the whole breast and you remove the axilla in continuity بتشيل البريست والاكزيلا بتبكيت الاكزيلا in continuity اوكي لكن كان في حاجه اقل من اكتر من كده اللي هي راديكال ان الراديكال مستكتبي وي يوز تو ريموف ذا بكتوراليس كنا بنشيل البكتوراليس ميجر وان control back muscles. In an extended radical, we used to remove, كمان, the internal memory nodes. بصوا بيعملوها ازاي ساعات؟ يرسموها كده بطريقة. هما بيحطوا واحدة في الوسط ويقولوا هنطلع منها وننزل ونطلع منها وننزل. لو حطينا ام ار ام في الوسط على ستاب كده الام ار ام، الام ار ام يعني ايه؟ هنعمل مستكتومي وتفضي الاكزيلا وبس. ممكن نطلع سلمه ثانيه. يبقى عملنا راديكال اللي شلنا فيها زياده عن المستكتومي زي الاكويشن شلنا فيها البكتوراليس. لكن ممكن نطلع سلمه كمان سوبر راديكال. السوبر راديكال نو ون داز ذيس ثينجز اني مور خلاص لكن السوبر راديكال كان يوز تو ريموف ذا انترنال ميموري نودز كانوا اول ما بدأوا يعملوا بس كانسر سيرفيكلي دي وير فيري فرستريتد why were they frustrated? Because they used to move the breast, the whole breast of the axilla, and they were very happy. The patient still died. فقالوا ايه طب تعالوا بقى until the memory nodes all الله ينشله فابتدى يعمل حاجة أكبر فthey were even more frustrated. عارفين if you do a lot of effort and you do not achieve any results you get really mad. If you do not exert an effort خلاص مش مهم. Until they started يعني making a few trials and so on and they discovered a very important fact that it does not matter how much breast you remove, it matters how much chemotherapy you give following the local treatment. Then what kills is not the breast cancer in the breast, what kills is the presence of metastasis. If you perform a very minor procedure in the breast and you get rid of the tumor in the breast and you do not give chemotherapy, you haven't done anything. If you perform it and you give chemotherapy, then the survival improves because you are managing the micrometastasis. فدي كانت فكرته فعشان كده احنا ايه we've abandoned completely a super radical radical اذا بنعمل يا modified radical يا اما بنصادها breast conservation. طبعا modified radical او radical او any of these procedures can be followed by can be followed by a
chemotherapy.
Okay, can be followed by radio, but can be followed by breast reconstruction.
Oh, okay.
من زي ما انتوا عارفين الجراحه كام نوع؟ الجراحه كام نوع؟ الجراحات عموما
Ectomy reconstruction.
بالظبط كده. Surgeries are of three types. There are ectomy, excisional dissection and surgery at a very primitive level. يلبس دايرة تعالوا نرميه. مش عارف البيت دايرة تعالوا نرميه. السبين دايرة يلا نرميه. فايتس a very primitive form. There can be another form more complicated that cannot be applied to anywhere in the body اللي هو reconstructive. Reconstructive. At the times, obviously, when you remove, you need to reconstruct. زي ما راح يشيل تيومر من الجلد ولا حاجة بعد كده. عنده مقرة لازم يغطيها. أو يشيل المعدة لازم بعد كده reconstruct bowel and anastomotic to the esophagus. طبعا في عمليات الهرنيا reconstructive ولا excisional؟ الاثنين. بس basically الريسكت طبعا كده الريسكت. طبعا الباي باسز. العمليات دي اسمه ثلاث مجموعات يا اما اكسيجنال ريسكشنال اكتوليز يا اما ريكونستركت بروسيدرز وطبعا يو ريموف يو مي ريكونستركت في ريميديال بروسيدرز فاحنا وين يو ريموف ذا بريست يو مي فيري ويل ريكونستركت واتفقنا على التيرم في جراح كده بيعمل اثنين مع بعض اسمه ايه؟ جراح بيعمل اونكوبلاستيك اونكوبلاستيك ملوش اسم هو ده اسم اصلا اونكوبلاستيك وهو بيعمل اونكولوجي وبلاستيك فاسمه اونكوبلاستيك اسمه دي اونكوبلاستيك سيرجن زي ما في جراح بيشيل اوراق ويعمل باسكال ريكونستراكشن اسمه دي اونكوباسكال اسمه دي اونكوبلاستيك يبقى يشيل التيوب وبعد كده يريكونستراكت بس ده له نقطه تانيه هنتكلم عليها بعدين دلوقتي هتركزوا معايا حته مهمه قوي ايه اللي يخلينا نختار ماستكتومي فيرسس بريست كونزرفيشن يعني دلوقتي احنا when a lady presents with breast cancer, you've got one of two surgical choices. Am I going to remove the whole breast or am I going to conserve upon the breast? Or again, the breast conservation in the form of one local excision, well, an MRM. الكلام ده كله أي كلام. لكن في الآخر, this is the practical choice. Am I going to perform an MRM versus a wide open excision? أكيد عندي selection criteria. ماليش كده بختار at random. لازم يبقى عندي selection criteria. مكتوبة هنا.
إيه؟
لا أول حاجة إحنا عاوزين ينفع لها إيه وبعدين ناخد رأيها إذا كان عاوزة تعمل اللي إحنا عاوزين نعمله. لكن هما في ثلاثة فاكتورز. الفاكتور الاولاني احنا هو احنا ليه why are we not removing the breast
cosmetic
for cosmetic purposes. We are not removing the breast for cosmetic purposes. But I want to make sure that we can remove the lump with a safety margin and enough breast remains for cosmesis to be retained. Well, if someone has got a very big mass and we remove the mass with a safety margin, you don't find enough breast in a small breast to maintain any cosmesis.
And we don't like a big DCIS component.
مش عاوزين يبقى فيها يعني when you remove the lump and you subject it to the histopathologist and then they tell you okay there is laser foci but there is a major component that is DCIS. DCIS and adductor and so insights. But of that contributing to more than 25 of the specimen, it means that there is a possibility of variances of recurrence. هي دي دلوقتي طبعا خلاص النقطة دي سامعينها هي دي مهمة قوي اللي هي ايه دلوقتي you got two options and you've got the pros and the cons and finally you've got selection criteria وده يمكن قلناها بسرعة كده لما اتكلمنا عن الثايرويد الثايرويد كانسر زي ما انتم عارفين راح ممكن يعني ثايرويد كانسر بثايرويدكتومي ولا لوبكتومي هي نفس الفكرة شايفين ماشية بنفس الطريقة With breast cancer, you can perform a mastectomy versus a wide open excision. Come on, the pros and cons are clear. If you preserve the breast or conserve on the breast, it's cosmetic and it's for psychological reasons and so on. If you remove the whole breast, it's again for psychological reasons because a few females will not want to worry about the remaining breast, but they will choose a mastectomy from the start. They will say, I do not want breast conservation. اوكي طيب ايه الكرايتيريا لازم يكون في سلكشن كرايتيريا مش هعملها ات راندوم فدي سلكشن كرايتيريا ار كونسيرند ويز ذا كوزمتيك ريزلت ذا انديكيشن تو جيف راديوثيرابي اند لاست بس نوت ليست زي ما بيقولوا دايما ذا اونكولوجيكال كومبوننت اللي هو انشورينج لو انسنس اوف ريكفرنس يبقى احنا هنقف عند كده النهارده هنكمل يوم ايه يا ربي ده يوم الاحد